Hey, you see these? They're the hottest tickets in this town. It's for the Academy Awards. And people will do anything to get one of these. Even become a movie star. But you don't need one. You're with me. So come on.
Chandler Pavilion in Los Angeles, California, the 56th annual Academy Award. From the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion in Los Angeles, the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences presents the 57th annual Academy Award. The 57th Annual Academy Awards is brought to you by Revlon. Revlon, the difference between looking good and looking great. And JCPenney, you're looking smarter than ever, JCPenney. And the Coca-Cola Company and your local Coca-Cola bottler. And General Electric. At GE, we bring good things to life. Once again, the one night in the year that is shared throughout the globe with arriving celebrities. From England, David Lean, candidate for Best Director. Diana Ross, who will perform one of the nominated songs. Here is the president of the Motion Picture Association of America, Hollywood's ambassador to the world, Mr. Jack Valenti. Candace Bergen with husband Louis Maul. Lindsay Cross, the Best Supporting Actress nominee. Steve Martin with current leading lady, Victoria Tennant. Here's Ron Howard, director of Splash. And Apollonia, leading lady in Purple Rain. From the accounting firm Pricewaterhouse, who tabulate the balloting and guarantee the secrecy and integrity of the results, Mr. Frank Johnson and Mr. Steve Kaplan. Here's Ray Parker Jr., nominated in the original song category. Victor Banerjee, who starred in Passage to India. Opera star Placido Domingo with pretty Cecilia Peck. Lynette McKee from the Cotton Club. Actor, producer, director Michael Douglas. The Electric Prince, nominated for original song score. Mr. Adolph Caesar, Best Supporting Actor nominee. Here's Jimmy Stewart, a Hollywood legend who will receive an honorary Oscar tonight, and Jessica Lange, nominated for Best Actress Honors. Robert Duvall, last year's Best Actor winner. Mr. Gregory Hines, a co-host tonight and star of The Cotton Club. The Family Bridges, Lloyd, Beau, and Jeff, a nominee as Best Actor for his performance in Starman. Jennifer Beals, one of tonight's Oscar presenters. Roland Jaffe, nominated for his direction of The Killing Fields. Going for her second Oscar tonight, Miss Sally Field, nominated for her supporting role in The Natural, Glenn Close. And Miss Sissy Spacek, another nominee for Best Actress. The last arrivees enter the theater, where we will join them in just a moment. And excitement of the 57th Annual Academy Awards.
Everything but clear the table.
GE, we bring the things to life.
1982, Diet Coke is introduced with a one-of-a-kind taste. 1983, Diet Pepsi reformulates its taste. But Diet Coke beats Diet Pepsi in taste tests across America. 1984, Diet Pepsi reformulates again to 100% NutraSweet, but Diet Coke with 100% NutraSweet beats Diet Pepsi again. 1985, Diet Coke is still one of a kind, still number one, and you are going to drink it just for the taste of it.
Live today's Chevrolet with Cavalier.
Fly the coupe, pop the top. The look is trim, thrills nonstop as the road rolls on.
Today's Cavalier has the electronic fuel-injected power and front drive you're looking for, plus an interior that comforts your very soul. Pick the Cavalier that fits your life.
Chevrolet announces low 8.8% financing for a limited time on all new Chevy Cavaliers.
Chevy.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for this evening, Mr. Jack Lemmon.
Welcome. Motion pictures, or call them moving pictures, or the movies, or cinema, or films, flicks, pics. We all love those magic shadows up there, being brave and funny and singing, dancing, and winning the race, losing the girl, or winning the girl, losing the race. Going to the pictures is a lifelong habit. We start out getting in cheaper because we're young. We keep right on going till we get in cheaper because we're old. And again this year, as in the 56 gone by, movie fans around the world, and that includes everyone up on this stage, gather to name the best of those already recognized as outstanding. People whose work is considered better than the work done by those people who thought their own work was pretty terrific to begin with. And since the Academy Awards began in 1929, of course, there has been a great proliferation of other award shows. Proliferation. It is now possible. In fact, it's happened. You can get an award. An award show can win an award for being the best award show from another award show. I don't know. Somebody doesn't win an award every other night, or America gets the bends. Brevity, as we know, is the soul of wit. In that sense, we hope to have a very soulful evening for you. I don't think that you can get more brief or wittier than the late writer Goodman Ace. He reviewed the movie version of I Am a Camera by saying, no like her. Now, we hope to say more than just two words about the movies being honored here tonight, but not a lot more. Excellence has a way of speaking for itself. Now, there's a number of people I'll be introducing to you. Just 2,000, 3,000. To begin with, here is the president of the Motion Picture Academy, himself a former Oscar winner for art direction, Mr. Gene Allen.
Seishay and Ni Hao. If that sounded the least bit Chinese to you, you were absolutely right. I was just saying thank you and hello to the People's Republic of China, which joins us tonight for the first time, along with Poland and Denmark, expanding our worldwide audience for the Oscars to 77 countries, from Albuquerque to Altoona, Altoona to Zimbabwe. Whether it's been seen live or by satellite, it is estimated that this award show will be seen by upwards of 1 billion people. In a world of numbers, that is an impressive number. You can only really appreciate what 1 billion people look like if you've ever tried to find your car after one of these shows. It is perhaps my greatest privilege as president of the Motion Picture Academy to be able to welcome so many varied and diverse cultures, so many colors, tongues, and tastes, to share with the members of the Academy their pride in the selection of those whose artistic and technical efforts they consider the best of the year. Not wanting to keep even one of the 1 billion of you waiting a second longer, let me say welcome once more and thank you for joining us.
How many times have we heard those immortal words, no one wins an award like this all by himself? Well, no one can hand out a couple of dozen of those suckers without help or two. And the movies being a collaborative art, I called on a few other members of the acting persuasion. Happily, they all said they would help. And I would like you now to meet my co-hosts, representing some of Hollywood's best new talents, talent nurtured both in films and on the stage. They are Candace Bergen.
This year's nominated songs. We don't want you to get scared. Don't be frightened. Remember, it's only a song. Performed by Ray Parker Jr. It's Ghostbusters. Look out.
Goodness. I ain't afraid of that ghost. you better call.
Dancing, a training, or staying at home. We've got your color. For shopping, or christening, or skiing downhill. We've got your color. For swimming, or hunting, or tying the knot. We've got your color. 269 creamy shades for your lips. 143 long-wearing shades for your fingertips. Revlon, the difference between looking good and looking great.
If you visited all the places some nationwide long-distance companies don't serve, you'd be on the road a long time. There are a lot of services you take for granted with AT&T that most companies don't have, like calling from anywhere to anywhere, operator service, and immediate credit for wrong numbers. Looks like most companies still have a long way to go to measure up to AT&T. The more you hear, the better we sound.
Reach out and touch someone.
Look at you, you're not the same as you were yesterday. You're looking smarter, you're on the move, and going your own way. And JCPenney's changed with you.
The Wyndham Collection, a coordinated career wardrobe of tailored jackets, skirts, and fine silk blouses, designed to help you take on life's many challenges with style. Wyndham at JCPenney.
You're looking smarter than ever, JCPenney.
The complex world of video systems, now made simpler than ever by the General Electric Advanced Video System. It's a video camera with a quick check monitor, a VCR with an easy-to-use visual programmer, and the GE Answer Center to answer your questions anytime about GE video products. Never has video technology been this simple. GE, we bring good things to life.
The chances of receiving an Oscar for your first major acting role are roughly the same as hitting a hole in one to celebrate winning the Irish sweepstakes. But here to present this year's award for the best supporting actor is the gifted woman who did just that her very first time out by winning the Oscar for best supporting actress in the year of Living Dangerously, Miss Linda Hunt.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The five actors we're about to celebrate have each taken a different path on their journey here this evening. I know that none of them think of this evening as their final goal. The final goal, if any, lies within the work and in a private sense of challenge and achievement. To be chosen as the best for a piece of work is a welcome prize. To know that you've done it in a way that's best for you is every bit as sweet the best performance by an actor in a supporting role. Adolf Caesar in A Soldier's Story. John Malkovich in Places in the Heart. Noriyuki Pat Morita in The Karate Kid. Hang S. Noor in The Killing Fields. Ralph Richardson in Greystoke, The Legend of Tarzan, Lord of the Apes. My deepest congratulations to the four gentlemen with us tonight. God's blessing be with Sir Ralph Richardson. The winner is Hang S. Noor in The Killing Fields.
Unbelievable, but so is my entire life. I wish to thank all members of Motion Picture Academy for this great honor. I thank Louis Putnam, Ron Chaffee, for giving me this chance to act for the first time in The Killing Fields. And I share this award to my friend Sam Morrison, Dick Brown, Sri Schumer, and also Pat Gordon, the casting lady who found me for this role. And I thank Warner Brothers for helping me tell my story to the world, let the world know what happened in my country. And I thank God, Buddha, that tonight I'm even here. Thank you, man. Thank you.
Throughout the evening, we'll be showing scenes from the five films nominated for the highly coveted Best Picture Award. Scenes that we hope will convey a sense of why the members of the Academy considered these efforts movie-making at its best. First, Amadeus, the story of the composer Mozart and his extraordinary talent, which unwittingly inspired the envy and the hatred of the far less gifted contemporary.
Thank you. Before presenting the next award, may I just say that from time to time we are sadly reminded that the sense of adventure, of risk, and of danger that we so love in our movies is often shared by the people behind the camera, and often can result in tragedy. Only days ago, production designer Richard Dawking, location manager Brian Coates, and pilot Dick Koch, three of my co-workers, perished while scouting locations in Morocco. The show can go on, but does exact a price. Now for best achievement in documentary short subjects. The nominees are The Children of Sung Ching Ling, a look at China's efforts to improve health care for children and family planning for mothers. Gary Bush and Paul T.K. Lin, producers. Code Gray, Ethical Dilemmas in Nursing, an illuminating look at the responsibilities of nursing. Ben Achtenberg and Joan Sawyer, producers. The Garden of Eden, about why protecting the world's plant and animal life is critical to our future. Lawrence R. Hott and Roger M. Sherman, the producers. The Recollections of Pavlovsk, the dedication and perseverance of one woman to preserve a unique monument to Russian architecture. Irina Kalinina, producer. And the Stone Carvers, a look at the last few traditional stone carvers still working in America. Marjorie Hunt and Paul Wagner, producers. The winner is the Stone Carvers, Marjorie Hunt and Paul Wagner.
Of course, we'd like to thank the Academy for this award. We want to thank the terrific crew and very sensitive crew that worked with us on the film. We want to thank the great organizations that stood behind us with their financial support, always an important element, the National Endowment for the Arts, the DC Community Humanities Council, and the Morrison Gwendolyn Kafritz Foundation. Also want to personally thank my good friends and my family.
I'd like to thank Alan and my family, especially my mother, who has believed in the film from the very beginning. The Office of Folklife Programs at the Smithsonian, who so supported the film, and most of all, the Stone Carvers, Roger Morici, Vincent Palumbo, Constantine Zuffos, and Frank Zick. This is for you.
Thank you.
Makers of documentaries are not allowed the luxury of fiction or fancy. They are the only people in the film industry who have to deal in the truth. They are a very lonely group. Generally dedicated to a cause, we are about to provide one of them with a cause for celebration. The nominees for the best achievement in documentary features are High Schools, a realistic glimpse of high school life inside and outside the classroom. Charles Guggenheim and Nancy Sloss, producers. In the Name of the People, the odyssey of four American filmmakers in rebel-held areas of El Salvador. Alex W. Dressler and Frank Christopher, producers. Marlena, a complex portrait of the incomparable Marlena Dietrich. Karel Birka and Zev Braun, producers. Streetwise, a chronicle of homeless and runaway teenagers. Cheryl McCall, producer. The Times of Harvey Milk, a film about American values in conflict. Robert Epstein and Richard Schmeichen, producers. And the winner is The Times of Harvey Milk, Robert Epstein and Richard Schmeichen, producers. Thank you.
Richard and I would like to thank our wonderful crew, particularly Deborah Hoffman, Mark Isham, Harvey Firestein, Greg Bex, Tim O'Shea, and Francis Reed. Personally, I would like to thank my partner in life, John Wright, for all his support during the 6 years it took to get this film made. And finally, a simple thank you to Harvey Milk for reminding us that it's possible to live life with a sense of social responsibility and a sense of humor. I would like to thank all the many, many people who supported the film, the volunteers, donors, institutional support, our distributor, TC Films. And I would like to also thank Harvey Milk for his courage, for his pride in being gay, and for his hope that one day we will all live together in a world of mutual respect. Thank you.
May I now call your attention, please, to our musical director. Here, waving a baton instead of his own Oscar, is Mr. Bill Conti. Bill is conducting the orchestra now for the second of our nominated songs. It's Let's Hear It for the Boy, and it's sung by the great Denise Williams.
Have a real time. And would you like a family sedan improved by the engineers who designed Corvette?
You're kidding.
No, that's Celebrity Eurosport from today's Chevrolet. It's for people who love to drive. These engineers modified its steering, retuned its suspension, and turned it loose with smoother fuel-injected power. Like Corvette, Celebrity Eurosport is for people who love to drive.
You're not kidding.
Drive today, Chevy. Live today, Chevy.
Live it.
Chevy.
Revlon introduces a beautiful statistic. 7 out of 10 women have skin that is partly dry, partly oily. And so Revlon solves their problem with a remarkable makeup. Skin balancing makeup. It puts your skin in perfect balance with an uncommon texture, tone, and color. And so touchingly beautiful. Skin balancing makeup from Revlon for 7 out of 10 women.
What about the other 3?
Hey, you can't be all things to all women.
Tune for Willie Nelson and Kris Kristofferson in a special musical salute on the 57th Annual Academy Awards.
Friday, Webster's all new at 8/7 Central, and George is up to his old stunts. But who's to blame when Wesley chooses ballet over football?
It's Belvedere, isn't it?
It's Webster at its new time, 8/7 Central, followed by Mr. Belvedere Friday.
For great roast beef, any way you slice it. Arby's famous roast beef. Tangy beef and cheddar. Mouth-watering Arby's super. Sizzling bacon cheddar deluxe.
Welcome to Arby's, the right way you belong.
For lean, tender roast beef.
The right way you belong.
I care about you, the way you look, the way you set me free. I care about you, cause you're special to me.
We Americans think our cars are pretty special. And they are. So Valvoline makes specialized motor oils to meet their special needs. Like Valvoline All Climate for stop-and-go driving. And Valvoline Turbo 5 for turbocharged cars. Valvoline, because your car is special.
Cause you're special to me.
The 57th Annual Academy Awards are proudly shared with you by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. And brought to you by AT&T. The more you hear, the better we sound. And Revlon. Revlon, the difference between looking good and looking great. And Chevrolet. See today's Chevy, drive today's Chevy, live today's Chevy. And the Coca-Cola Company and your local Coca-Cola bottler.
Here to present the award for Best Achievement in Makeup are two women whose own natural beauty could render that particular category obsolete. From the Cotton Club, Miss Lynette McKee, and from A Woman in Red, Miss Kelly LeBrock.
The makeup artist has been an integral part of the movie since the beginning.
Influenced by stage techniques, early film actors looked as though they'd been made up in a bakery.
Yes, and as it happened with each of the movie-making crafts, makeup has become more and more advanced and more an art in itself.
From the 18th century far into the 21st, the work of this year's nominees covered a span of some 400 years. Depicting the effects of time on Mozart's nemesis,
Antonio Salieri.
In Greystoke, The Legend of Tarzan, Lord of the Apes, nominees Rick Baker and Paul Angelin created makeup for both man and beast. Applied his artistry to the aging process and brought a chilling realism to the face of actor Keir Dulay. And the winners for Best Achievement in Makeup are Paul LeBlanc and Dick Smith for Amadeus.
I've been a makeup artist for 40 years, years full of excitement and happiness, many friends, and this moment is just the greatest of that time. I'm very grateful for it, and especially to Murray Abraham, whose genius brought my old Salieri makeup to such glorious life. Paul and I are especially honored because we know how extraordinary the creations of Rick Baker and Mike Westmore were, and we're proud to be their colleagues. Paul did all the other makeups besides the Salieri one, and please say your words. Thank you very much.
I just want to say thank you to Tom Sternberg for introducing me to Saul Zanz, who introduced me to Milos Forman, who introduced me to Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Thank you.
Gregory.
Amy.
Next up is the best achievement in sound.
I heard that. Yes.
The nominees in this field share a proud heritage.
Oh, my. He is making a the
You're listening to one of the first sound films ever made. Movies hadn't decided yet whether to talk or to quack. Sound was Hollywood's answer to a threat by a growing competitor. America was hooked on a new piece of talking furniture called the radio.
Given silent films, a voice was not all peaches and cold cream. Popular screen idols became instant has-beens as audiences found they had strange accents and high-pitched voices much like their own.
Getting sound recorded was no easy process either, as movie professionals became overnight amateurs. The public fell in love with the talkies, so sound, like the gum on the floor, has been with us ever since. Action!
Sound technicians today use sophisticated technology to record sound on the set. During editing, additional music and sound effects are added to the soundtrack.
To the point where one bleep is worth a thousand words.
For Best Achievement in Sound, the nominees are
Mark Berger, Tom Scott, Todd Buckelhide, and Chris Newman for Amadeus.
It sounded good. Do another.
Bill Varney, Steve Maslow, Kevin O'Connell, and Nelson Stull for Dune.
Graham V. Hartstone, Nicholas Le Miserier, Michael A. Carter, and John Mitchell for A Passage to India.
Richard Portman and David Ronnie for The River.
Michael J. Cohut, Aaron Rochin, Carlos De Larios, and Gene S. Canamesa for 2010. May we hear the sound of the envelope tearing, please.
The winners are Mark Berger, Tom Scott, and Todd Buckelhide, and Chris Newman for Amadeus.
Thank you.
thanks to Saul Zanz and Milos Forman for the opportunity to work on Amadeus, and to my wife Susan Wangrath, Matthew, and Anya.
Thanks to our San Francisco sound editors, Roy Siegel, Alice Caldwell, and Cotty Keese.
Thanks to John Strauss, whose wonderfully creative work on this film made my work on it quite pleasurable. Also Mark Adler for the great tracks, and Neville Mariner for some wonderful readings of the music, and finally Wolfgang for writing it down.
Kenny Weston, Neil Fallon, Bob Gorlin, Peter and Hope Newman, all the people in Czechoslovakia, with profound gratitude, thank you.
If a motion picture is the work of artists and scientists, few talents can qualify as both.
Except for the cinematographer. Using heavy, often cumbersome machinery, the cinematographer mixes light, picture, and performance to make a unique contribution to a group effort.
This year's nominees reflect the high degree of excellence of these masters, and they are...
Miroslav Ondrejcek for Amadeus.
Chris Menges for The Killing Fields.
Caleb Deschanel for The Natural.
Ernest Day for A Passage to India.
Vilmos Zsigmond for The River.
And the winner is... The winner is Chris Menges for The Killing Fields. Chris isn't here. We'll take it.
Mr. Gary Crist is a fine dancer. He also may be the luckiest man in the building tonight because he is performing the third nominated song, Against All Odds, Take a Look at Me Now, with the quite spectacular Miss Anne Reineke.
How can I just let you walk away? Just let you leave without a trace? When I stand here taking every breath with you, you're the only one who really knew me at all. How can you just walk away from me when all I can do is watch you leave? 'Cause we share the laughter and the pain, share the tears. Take a look at me now. Well, there's just an empty space, and there's nothing left here to remind me. Just the memory of your face. Well, take a look at me now. Well, there's just an empty space, and you coming back to me is against all the odds, and that's what I've got to face.
Small businesses have developed their own methods of communicating. Now there's a better way. The Merlin telephone system from AT&T. It's an intercom, a conference caller, and has 40 features you can select.
Yes, sir.
So Merlin can grow along with your business. Call today about Merlin. 1-800-247-7000.
To present the Oscar for Best Supporting Actress is a fellow who began to develop his own acting career while still a very young man. And a string of credits later, he's still developing his skills. I don't know, it must be something in the water out here because he's still a very young man. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ryan O'Neill.
I was very pleased to be asked to deal with this particular category tonight. It was a number of years ago when my own daughter came into the business that I became quite familiar with supporting actresses. 1984 showed us once again what a wealth of gifted women filmmakers can call upon. While only five are the finalists, they represent scores more who enhance any film in which they appear. Those five are Peggy Ashcroft in A Passage to India. Glenn Close in The Natural. Lindsay Krause in Places in the Heart. Christine Lotti in Swing Shift. Geraldine Page in The Pope of Greenwich Village. And the winner is Peggy Ashcroft in A Passage to India.
Accepting the Supporting Actress Award for Peggy Ashcroft is Miss Angela Lansbury.
I think you must know how infinitely honored I feel to have the privilege of accepting this Oscar for my dear friend, Peggy Ashcroft. I know it would have been her dearest wish to be here with you all on this incredibly happy, joyous occasion for her, but I also know you understand the circumstances which prevented it. I personally would just like to say that I think it is so marvelous that after an illustrious career in the theater for so many years, Peggy should at last be visible to all those millions of moviegoers who have and will continue to enjoy her consummate artistry, her delicacy and beauty. That we should be able to share that all over the world with her in the movies is an enormous coup for all of us. Thank you.
You know, I gotta tell you, that being up here really does give one a sense of power, you know. I know, for instance, right this very moment, I can bring a smile to your lips, and I can make you feel just that little bit better by simply introducing Mr. Gene Kelly.
Tell a story here in Hollywood about George Jessel. Georgie spoke at so many funerals, there was a feeling he got a royalty every time somebody died. But one time, delivering perhaps his third eulogy of the week, Georgie was going on and on extolling the virtues of the guest of honor when suddenly he looked down at the dear departed and said, "My God, I know this man." Inside joke, it's true. Well, I do know this man I'm about to introduce. I've known him for 40 years. Well, I've known a lot of people for 40 years, but I've liked and admired him that long as well. While his work as a showman has been seen and admired on a global basis, it's for his lifelong devotion and participation in countless public service activities, including the Olympics, that he has been chosen by the Academy Board of Governors to receive the prestigious Gene Herschel Humanitarian Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David L. Wolpert.
Thank you, Gene, for that most gracious reception. And thanks to the Board of Governors of the Academy for this most wonderful honor. Few people have the opportunity in their lifetime to serve their city, their state, and even their country in a single event of joy and friendship. I was given that honor recently during the games of the 23rd Olympiad. I rejoice in receiving this award, but I do so not only for myself, but the outstanding Hollywood talents and the 60,000 citizens of Los Angeles and Southern California who volunteered their time and energy for weeks, months, and some for years. They all share the Olympic dream and help to create a moment in history. In the spirit of this Gene Herschel Humanitarian Award, and the words of songwriters Ashford and Simpson, sung at the Olympic opening ceremonies, reach out and touch somebody's hand and make this a better world if you can. I thank you.
Art direction. What is it? Who does it? Why? And how much? And where are they? And here we are. Art direction. I don't know. Hi, I'm Steve Martin. They asked me to say that. I told them I didn't have to. They said, Steve, we're in China tonight. I said, they know me in China. Billions of them. Anyway, I can't walk down the street in China. Steve, how's it going? What? Hey, what are you doing here? Tonight, we honor the best art direction. And to illustrate how important good art direction is, we're going to show three famous unknown scenes where the art direction was so wrong, they actually had to reshoot them. First,
what about you?
This little-known scene from Casablanca.
No, Richard, no. What has happened to you last night?
Last night, we said a great many things. You said I was to do the thinking. One thing, you're getting on that plane with Victor where you belong.
This scene, around the world in 80 days. And finally, from the big broadcast of 1938.
Of radio.
Tonight's nominees knew better, and they are, for Amadeus, art direction, Patrizia von Brandenstein, set decoration, Carol Czerny. The Cotton Club, art direction, Richard Silbert, set decoration, George Gaines and Les Bloom. The Natural, art direction, Angelo Graham, Mel Bourne, James J. Murakami, and Speed Hopkins, set decoration, Bruce Weintraub. Passage to India, art direction, John Box and Leslie Tompkins, set decoration, Hugh Scape. 2010, art direction, Albert Brenner, set decoration, Rick Simpson. And the winners are Patrizia von Brandenstein for Amadeus, the set decoration, Carol Czerny.
Thanks to Saul Zance and Milos Forman and Peter Schaffer and to Miroslav Andrzejczyk for photographing it, and to the people and the country and the culture in Czechoslovakia, which they so generously shared with us, especially Karol Kocsi, Joseph Rabashinsky, and my interpreter, Anna Maria Kolasheva.
I thank you very much, with co-production with Patricia, and I thank Miloš Forman and Saul Zance to my chance. Thank you very much.
On March 17th, the Academy held a very special dinner at the Beverly Hilton Hotel. And here with highlights of that evening is someone with countless credits as an actress and a brand new one as an author. A woman who to this day will not step into a shower without a security guard, Miss Janet Leigh.
Thank you, Jeff. Welcome to the Science and Technical Award Dinner, where we took the opportunity to present two additional awards. The first is named for Gordon E. Sawyer, who established standards of technical excellence, which tonight's recipient typifies, Mr. Linwood G. Dunn.
Well, I thank you so much for this very great honor. It is certainly a thrill, and I really extend my thanks to the Scientific or Technical Awards Committee of the Academy. God bless you all.
The second award is a Special Achievement Award for sound effects editing of The River, Ms. Kay Rose.
This is wonderful. Unbelievably wonderful. It's the fulfillment of a long-time dream that goes back to that first movie I ever saw. Thank you all for fulfilling that dream.
Our congratulations to Lynn Dunn and Kay Rose.
You know, when you consider that a dozen nominations were garnered by just three pictures this year, Country, The River, and Places in the Heart, then you don't need an outbuilding to fall on you to get the idea that Hollywood went back to the land this year, the heartland, rural America. Each film depicted the hardships and challenges, the courage, the doggedness that go with working the soil. And in celebration of the spirit of those people, here are Willie Nelson and Kris Kristofferson.
Thank you.
just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends. Insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. Making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. Making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
All right, thank you very much. We'd like to ask Miss Lynette and the team to come out and help us do amazing work.
Spend the weekends with family and friends. That's why AT&T saves you 60% on long distance every weekend, and they don't stop with savings. They give you service, too. Calling from anywhere to anywhere. Operator service, calls that sound as close as you feel, and 60% off.
Joe, knew you'd make it somehow.
Savings and service. That's AT&T. The more you hear, the better we sound.
Reach out and touch someone.
In all the universe, there's never been anything like the new size Chevy Astro.
Chevy Astro
stands alone with the only V6 available in a van. Vortec V6 power that rivals a V8 and the highest towing capacity available, up to 5,000 pounds in a size that fits your garage.
Chevy Astro.
When it comes to new ideas in vans, nothing works like a Chevy van.
Never will eyeshadow ever be the same again. Not since Revlon created Customize, a unique compact you can fill and refill with Revlon shadows you choose. Just the gorgeous Revlon colors you want to have. Customize your eye look with a remarkable compact you fill and refill with Revlon colors you choose. Customize, only by Revlon. Revlon, the difference between looking good and looking great.
The 57th Annual Academy Awards with Shirley MacLaine, Jennifer Beal, Kirk Douglas, and Burt Lancaster will return in a moment.
Tomorrow, join two special couples for two exciting hours. First on Magruder and Loud.
I have something to tell you.
Jenny finds out she's pregnant.
I really want this baby.
And Malcolm gets some on-the-job training.
I'm scared.
We're going to do this.
Then Dave and Maddie take a ride on the Murder Express.
Don't touch that man. You don't know where he's been.
Bet you can't guess who done it.
Who?
Take a stand. It's Moonlighting, the show everyone's talking about, right after Magruder and Loud, all starting at 9, 8 Central, tomorrow.
Sometimes a simple river crossing isn't so simple. And when you've got him back, it's your turn.
Bush.
Head for the beer brewed natural as a mountain stream, for a taste as smooth as its name.
Bush.
Head for the bush beer.
Head for the mountains.
Miss Candace Bergen and Mr. William Hurt.
If art imitates life, special effects imitate the fantastic.
When you see something on the screen that couldn't possibly happen, that's a special effect. Thanks to special visual effects, movies can go anywhere on Earth called for in the script, or even beyond. In 2010, artists used the latest satellite photographs to recreate the surfaces of planets. Model makers spent months preparing miniature spaceships so that when photographed close up, they appeared authentic down to the last rivet.
Actors themselves became special effects as they dangled from wires to simulate the weightlessness of outer space, from high in the heavens to the bowels of the earth. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom provided special effects designers with an unusual challenge: create the most hair-raising chase ever filmed in a mine tunnel. They did it without ever lifting a shovel.
Through the use of miniatures, the special effects team in California carefully integrated their work with footage shot in England using the real actors, whose heads are a little harder to swivel. A specially designed camera created the roller coaster effect of the cars speeding crazily down the track.
After 2 years of planning and shooting, the end result left both audiences and actors screaming in terror. In Ghostbusters, the special effects took a tongue-in-rubber-cheek approach, aiming for humor rather than painstaking realism.
Okay, who brought the dog?
The models shown here became special effects stars. Instead of being photographed in frame-by-frame animation style, these terrible-tempered blobs were manipulated by puppeteers. Ghostbuster Dan Aykroyd tries out a few special effects of his own to show them he ain't afraid.
Ah! Ah!
Whatever the mind can envision, these nominees for visual effects can execute and deliver. They are...
Ghostbusters, Richard Edlund, John Bruno, Mark Vargo, and Chuck Gaspar.
Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, Dennis Muren, Michael McAllister, Lorne Patterson, and George Gibbs.
2010, Richard Edlund, Neil Crapella, George Jensen, and Mark Stetson.
And the winner is...
Oh, boy. This is it.
The winners are Dennis Muren, Michael McAllister, Lorne Patterson, and George Gibbs for Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
Well, thank the Academy and Steven Spielberg, George Lucas, Kathy Kennedy, Frank Marshall, and Robert Watts, everybody at Industrial Light and Magic.
I'd like to thank Elliot Scott, the production designer, for asking me to work with him, and thank Steven Spielberg for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
There's about 100 other people at ILM to thank. We don't have time, so I'd like to thank a few of them. They are Bruce Nicholson, Michael Owens, Barbara Gallucci, Pat Sweeney, Howie Stein and the entire editorial department, and Pat Fitzsimmons and the incredible ILM Grip department. Thank you.
I'd also like to especially throw in a thanks for George Lucas. It's our 10th year this year. And also the model shop, which is about 30 of us. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Killing. Reels, based on a true experience. Two friends separated by war in Cambodia and reunited only after years of physical and personal hell.
Academy is pleased to present an honorary award, not to an individual, but to an organization which has enriched the lives of us all. Established in 1965 by the federal government, the National Endowment for the Arts has, among other achievements, guaranteed the survival of thousands of cultural organizations that would otherwise have vanished. Financial support for a variety of cultural and performing arts needs, or as Leonard Bernstein said, to try to bring the best of everything to the American public. Through its generous contributions and matching grants, the endowment has helped make dramatic presentations such as Theater in America a regular fixture of public broadcasting. Series on the order of Jazz in America and the highly acclaimed Dance in America have given nationwide exposure to artists whose talents might have been shared only with smaller, more specialized audiences. In this pre-recorded age,
The endowment has given us the thrill of actual performances by underwriting such programs as Live from the Met Operatic Series. In the world of film, typical endowment-sponsored productions have been the Academy Award-winning documentary The Bolero and the moving look at black spiritual music in Say Amen, Somebody. Individual creativity and imagination are in films such as An Eames Celebration, Several Worlds of Charles and Ray Eames. The endowment nurtures the future without neglecting the past. Through its contributions, irreplaceable early films are being transferred from dangerous and disintegrating nitrate prints to more stable, safer, positive safety film. It's a tedious and risky process, but it's the only way the heritage of Hollywood can be preserved. Example, the difference between this old print of Becky Sharp...
Did you or did you not promise that Lord Stane and heavenly appointed to some post?
...and this restored version.
He thinks you'd make a very fine consul at some distant spot.
When? When? I come to when?
On the subject of motion pictures, there's the American Film Institute. Established by the endowment, the institute provides young filmmakers valuable training in all phases of motion picture production. On this 20th anniversary of its founding, we honor an organization whose funds have allowed us to enjoy and encourage our native and bountiful talent. Whether it be film or television, music or museums, the dance or regional theater, the National Endowment for the Arts has left a permanent mark on the cultural landscape of this country. Here to accept the award is the chairman of the National Endowment of the Arts, Mr. Frank Hotzel.
Thank you. The National Endowment for the Arts and my boss, President Reagan, are very grateful to the Academy for this honor. The real credit goes to the hundreds who've served over 20 years on our National Council and panels, and to my predecessors and the staff. Let me also acknowledge the nonpartisan support of now 5 administrations and 10 Congresses. The endowment assists artistic excellence and helps bring it to all Americans. In this country, it is the American people who are the real patrons. This is an award we share with the nation. Film includes all of the arts. Half of Americans' films produced prior to 1952 have been lost. We want to make sure that Gene Kelly is dancing in the rain 300 years from now, and that's why the endowments joined with the American Film Institute to found the National Center for Film and Video Preservation. We're here tonight to honor the best. Let's join together to keep the best alive for the future.
Miss Amy Irving.
Perform the fourth of our best song contenders, Footloose. Here of fame is Miss Debbie Allen.
it be, ladies?
Seven up.
You must be from another planet.
What makes you say that?
Well, hasn't everyone on Earth heard that Sprite tastes better than 7-Up?
Sprite?
Yeah, it even won the taste test.
Test?
The one where more people preferred that great lime in taste?
Sprite. This civilization is more advanced than we thought.
The way they taste the Sprite.
Look at you. You're all the rage.
Halston 3.
Look at you. Look how you've changed.
From head to toe.
Just look at you. And JCPenney's changing too.
The Halston 3 collection. Because there's nothing more beautiful than a confident woman.
You're looking smarter than ever, JCPenney.
Thursday, the men from Wildside are playing hardball.
Looks like the Chamber of Commerce of Wildside is going on another hunt.
So stay on the good side of the men from Wildside. Then, for Charles Durning and Stephanie Farrisee, there's no turning back. Will these unlikely detectives ever see eye to eye?
We're not going to get much of a chase in tonight. Why don't we meet next week when we all have new tires?
It all starts at 8, 7 Central, Thursday.
Michael Douglas.
Here to present the Screenplay Awards are two gentlemen who last performed for Oscar 27 years ago. I'm pleased and very proud to say that I've known them both all my life, one perhaps a little bit longer. Mr. Burt Lancaster and Mr. Kirk Douglas.
Well, I guess, Burt, you haven't been nominated this year.
No, you haven't been either, Kirk.
Congratulations.
Great not to be pleading for it, great not to be pleading for it. Who said they make such nice forget?
And anyone who says it's nothing, just a snob.
And those fellas who want it just can't get a job. We'll take our chances. If some producer can hear, it's great not to be nominated, great not to be nominated. Find us something more. Next.
Bert, tell me, who are those kids?
Child actors, obviously.
Can you seriously, Bert, can you believe we were ever that age?
I can't believe on this one.
Gentlemen, please.
You know, if I knew he was going to do so well, I'd have been much nicer to him when he was little.
It's too late.
Here you go, Bert.
The five nominated best screenplays written directly for the screen testify to the imagination and invention of the screenwriter.
They deal with life on both sides of the law.
Life on the East Coast, life on the West, and at one point in between.
Life on the land and love under the sea.
They are Beverly Hills Cop, screenplay by Daniel Petrie Jr., story by Danilo Bach and Daniel Petrie Jr.
Broadway Danny Rose, written by Woody Allen.
El Norte, screenplay by Gregory Nava and Anna Thomas.
Places in the Heart, written by Robert Benton.
Splash, screenplay by Lowell Gantz, Babalu Mandel, and Bruce J. Friedman.
screen story by Bruce J. Friedman, based on a story by Brian Grazer. And it's written that the winner is Robert Benton for Places in the Heart.
Great many people to thank and not much time. I would like to thank Mr. John Malkovich, Ms. Lindsay Krause, Mr. Danny Glover, Mr. Ed Harris, Amy Madigan, Yankton Hatton, Jenny James. I would especially like to thank Ms. Sally Field. Without her genius and her courage, I would not be standing here tonight. I owe deep debt of gratitude to Carol Littleton, to Nestor Almendros, and most of all to Arlene Donovan. I would also like to thank Mr. Cohn and to all the people at TriStar. David, Victor, Gary, and Sidney Pollack. And mostly to my family and here and in Waxahachie and Texas and to the people of Waxahachie. Thank you very much.
Five nominees for Best Screenplay based on material from another medium showed no less boldness in the variety of subjects they tackled.
From a man who was a musical genius to one who was raised by beasts.
From colonialism to racism.
To the human devastation of war.
Amadeus, screenplay by Peter Shaffer.
Greystoke, The Legend of Tarzan, Lord of the Apes. Screenplay by P.H. Wasik and Michael Austin.
The Killing Fields, screenplay by Bruce Robinson.
A Passage to India, screenplay by David Lean.
A Soldier's Story, screenplay by Charles Fuller. And the winner is Peter Shaffer for Amadeus.
I'd like to thank the Academy for this distinguished present. I know my colleagues, and there are so many of them, attached to this film. You'll forgive me tonight if I mention only one name, that of Miloš Forman. Mr. Forman, as I'm sure you know, is a remarkable and distinguished screenwriter in his own right, as well as a remarkable and distinguished director. And his contribution to the transference of my play to the screen was gigantic. We both decided that music would be the center of the film, and my great pleasure is that Mozart has now reached millions and millions of people who had not heard him before. Thank you very much.
Miss Anne Reinken and Mr. Jeff Bridges.
Speaking of movies.
Very smooth.
You know, a movie don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing.
Or march.
Or waltz.
Or minuet.
Or rag, or rock.
Or bop.
So if you want to score with a movie, you better have a good one.
The nominees for Best Achievement and Original Score are Indiana Jones, John Williams.
Randy Newman for The Natural.
Maurice Jarre for A Passage to India.
John Williams for The River.
Alex North for Under the Volcano.
And the winner is...
The winner is Maurice Jarre for Passage to India.
I was lucky Mozart was not eligible this year. I thank all the Academy, but especially my colleagues, composers, who nominated me this year, all the music branch. Thank you very much. David, thank you for the fourth time. And just all my friends all over the world, from Australia to Italy, by France, England, thank you. Thank you, everybody.
To qualify as an original song score, a score must contain five original songs.
Songs that serve a dramatic purpose, that move the story along.
So the nominees for Best Original Song Score are, for The Muppets Take Manhattan, Jeff Moss.
For Purple Rain, Prince.
And for songwriter, Kris Kristofferson. And the winner of a brand new 84 Oscar is...
The winner is Prince for Purple Rain.
Much. This is Lisa, and this is Wendy. Can I hold it? This is very unbelievable. I could never imagine this in my wildest dreams, and I would like to thank the Academy, Mr. Albert Magnoli, my manager Stephen, Bob, Joe, Bobby, Mark, and Matt, who couldn't be with us today, and most of all, God. Thank you very much.
Thank you. To be the next winner, as in, and the winner is... The work of the nominees for Best Costume Design must show a degree of flair, tastefulness, and be altogether pleasing to the eye. I believe the same may be said of Miss Jennifer Beals. A costume without actually seeing it is like being told about music without being able to hear it. Let us show you some of the works of our nominees for the Best Achievement in Costume Design. Theodore Pishtek for Amadeus. Heart.
Patricia Norris for 2010. For the Bostonians. Pishtek, Dramadeus.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the biggest and happiest day of my film career. I am very happy and proud, and for me it's unbelievable because it is my first American movie. I thank to the Academy of Motion Picture for the honor. And now, because the filmmaking is teamwork, I would like to send my thanks to all my collaborators in Czechoslovakia, in Italy, mainly to my girl assistant, Susanna Máchová. But the biggest thanks are to Miloš Forman, because he made the great film, and if the film is great, all other people on this movie, they have their own chance. Thank you, Miloš. Thank you.
If your hair doesn't have it, your hair's gotta get it, get strong. Get flexibility, your hair's gotta take it. You better go and get a Get Flex. Get Flex ability.
Flexible hair is strong hair. Get it with new Flex conditioner for firmed hair. Firms weakened hair, new Flex builds body. Curls bounce back, healthy looking, beautiful. That's strong, that's flexibility.
Get strong, get Flex ability.
Flex bodybuilding conditioner and shampoo, new for permed hair.
A little confusion can be fun, but not when you're looking at long distance phone companies.
Because all companies aren't the same, you have to watch out for the unexpected. No operator service and no service from many small towns. Different levels of transmission quality and no immediate credit for wrong numbers. Only one company comes with no surprises. AT&T. The more you hear, the better we sound.
Reach out and touch someone.
You know what you like most about my clothes? You can be yourself in them.
You're looking smarter.
The colors, patterns, and textures all work together.
You're looking smarter.
So you can create great-looking outfits. Outfits that express your individuality, not mine.
You're looking smarter.
That's my idea of fashion.
The Lee Wright Collection at JCPenney.
You're looking smarter than ever.
The 57th Annual Academy Awards will soon continue with Jack Lemmon, Steven Spielberg, and James Stewart in the award for Best Actor.
Friday, now at 9, 8 Central, is an all-new Benson with a statue in his honor?
I'm sure the pigeons will enjoy that.
Then Eileen Brennan's battle rages on with Ed Asner.
Set a good example for Timothy by not being yourself.
Off the Rack, right after Benson, all starting at 9, 8 Central Friday.
New symbol of quality in the meat department at Eagle. Five-star meats.
Hey, these are only four stars, pal. We're looking for fives.
Our five-star symbol means it's the best quality and value we can offer.
Two-star chicken! No way! You call me when you got fives.
And if you're not pleased, we'll give you your money back.
Five-star? Five-star? Hey, that guy's three-star. Lose it.
Five-star meats, the new symbol of quality at Eagle.
For great roast beef, any way you slice it, Arby's Amos Roast Beef. Tangy beef and cheddar. Mouth-watering Arby's Super. Sizzling bacon cheddar deluxe.
Welcome to Arby's, the right way you belong.
For lean, tender roast beef,
the right way you belong.
What would you do for $1 million cash?
For $1 million cash, I'd climb that building.
That's a very high building, Walter.
I've taken that into consideration, Eunice.
42 stories high!
42 stories high, Walter.
42 stories!
You know, you could win $1 million cash in Cashbox Instant Lottery.
That is a thought, Walter.
That is a thought, Eunice.
52 stories high!
An animated short film is one that employs no live actors, only animated ones.
Who are, of course, represented by animated agents.
An animated short film may not run over 30 minutes.
And neither should we.
The nominees are Charade, John Minnis, producer.
Dr. DeSoto, Morton Schindel, and Michael Sporn, producers.
Paradise, Ishi Patel, producer.
And the winner is?
The winner is Charade, John Minnis, producer.
I find myself in a wonderful position. This is the second acceptance speech I've given in the last week, and that's unbelievable. I try not to repeat the first speech I made, with the exception of thanking Ann Sandow for her support, not only during the making of this film, but for her support during my career change, so it was. When I was a lad in Birmingham, England, my mother used to deliberately take me out of school to go and see a picture with her on a Wednesday afternoon, and I think it was more for company than foresight, but I'd like to say hello to my mother back in England and my sister Mary, and briefly I'd like to say thanks to Telefilm, Michael Mills for getting the film down here, and the Academy. Thank you.
Turner and Mr. Tom Selleck.
For best achievement in live-action short films.
The ones that use live actors?
With hopefully live agents. The nominees, those producers who gave us three good things in very small packages are...
The Painted Door, Michael McMillan and Janice L. Flatt producers.
Tales of Meeting and Parting, Sharon Orrick and Leslie Linka Glatter producers.
Mike Hoover, producer. And...
winner is... Up, Mike Hoover, producer.
This took 7 years to make, and there were quite a few people that stuck with us. Thank you, Lynn and Dave Adams, Ed Caesar, and a special thanks to Timothy Wade Huntley. Thank you.
In A Passage to India, the dividing line between romance and desire is contrasted against the rigidity of 19th century British colonial India.
When I first met Shirley MacLaine, we spent a lot of time together in the apartment. Billy Wilder's, his apartment, the movie, the apartment. Shirley and I didn't really have a place that we could call our own. And I think the whole damn thing was better before I tried to fix it anyway. It has been one enormous kick to watch this girl develop into such a gifted performer, author, and a very dynamic woman. Ladies and gentlemen, last year's Oscar winner for Best Actress, Miss Shirley MacLaine.
Thank you. Best Actor. A really superb performance is an actor getting out of his own way, trusting that the character he's playing has a life of its own and allowing that character to be what it must be. The five actors nominated tonight have accomplished just that. For his role as a man consumed by envy of Wolfgang Mozart and Amadeus F. Murray Abraham. the being from another planet with much to teach us in Starman, Jeff Bridges. For his portrait of a man driven to self-destruction in Under the Volcano, Albert Finney. In the title role of the immortal musical prodigy Amadeus, Tom Hulce. And as the American reporter whose life is changed forever by the war in Southeast Asia in the killing field, Sam Waterston. The winner is F. Murray Abraham.
It would be a lie if I told you I didn't know what to say, because I've been working on this speech for about 25 years. But you were not going to hear any of those speeches, because none of the speeches were less than 45 seconds. You know, it's easy to gamble everything when you've got nothing to lose, and Milos Forman had a great deal to lose when he gave these brilliant roles to Tom Hulce and me, and his courage became my inspiration. There's only one thing that's missing for me tonight, and that is to have Tom Hulce standing by my side. Half of this statue belongs to my beloved wife, Kate. Thank you.
The last of our nominated songs to be sung by one of our first ladies of music. Here is Miss Diana Ross, and I just called to say I love you.
No summer skies.
In the third millennium, four adventurers came upon a city imprisoned in silence.
I notice you're drinking a Diet Coke. You must love that one-of-a-kind taste. Oh, yeah, lots of people do. Now, you take Diet Pepsi. They said they changed, but Diet Coke still beats them. In fact, in a blind taste test, more people preferred the taste of Diet Coke to Diet Pepsi. Now, to me, that says it all. This is great. You love Diet Coke. I love Diet Coke. You're blonde. I'm blonde. You can read French.
Diet Coke. The taste that won is one-of-a-kind.
Hey, I notice you're drinking a Diet Coke.
Century. It's one of the rewards you get for playing the game and winning.
Coming down the road, yeah. Wouldn't you feel so at home, yeah?
Buick Century. Comfortable, stylish, solid, and very rewarding to drive.
Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
Mr. Gregory Hines.
The moment has arrived. The waiting is over. No composer should be asked to remain composed for so long. The nominees for Best Song are Against All Odds, Take a Look at Me Now from Against All Odds. Music and lyric by Phil Collins. Footloose from Footloose. Music and lyric by Kenny Loggins and Dean Pitchford. Ghostbusters from Ghostbusters. Music and lyric by Ray Parker, Jr. I Just Called to Say I Love You from A Woman in Red. Music and lyric by Stevie Wonder. Let's Hear It for the Boy from Footloose. Music and lyric by Tom Snow and Dean Pitchford. And the winner is Stevie Wonder.
I cannot believe it. I really cannot believe it. I must share this with you. It'll take just a second, I think. But all through Europe, I had dreams, and I would always wake up when I was at an award show, and the nominees were coming up, and they say, this song, and the winner is, I would wake up. But I never thought that this would happen. I never thought this would happen. I would like to accept this award, the name of Nelson Mandela. I'd like to thank, first of all, Ms. Dionne Warwick for allowing me this opportunity. I'd like to, thank Gene Wilder for thinking I might be able to do some songs for your film. Thank Orion Pictures. And thank Motown Records and my family and my crew. From my heart, I love you.
Editor finding himself with a lot of footage of an actor making a long speech or, say, presenting an award might wish that the director had shot some film of someone else so that if his mind went numb, he could cut away from the actor to the entrance of Geneviève Bugeaud. Thank you for coming.
And thank you.
Yeah. One of the biggest surprises I got when I started making movies was learning what a staggering effect editors have on the outcome of the film.
The editor is the loving, ruthless mother of the film. The editor gives it its breath and its rhythm. I need one now. The editor makes it whole. So for best achievement in film editing, they are...
Nina Donovich and Michael Chandler for Amadeus.
Barry Malkin and Robert Q. Lovett for The Cotton Club.
Jim Clark for The Killing Fields.
For A Passage to India.
John Cambern and Frank Morris for Romancing the Stone. And the winner is...
The chosen one is Jim Clark for The Killing Fields.
I'd like to thank the Academy very much for this tremendous award, which I'd love to share with all my fellow colleagues in London who worked extremely hard to make the best of a wonderful film. I would like also to thank David Putnam and Ian Smith for giving me the opportunity to cut the picture, and to Warner Brothers and Goldcrest for so courageously funding it, and most of all to Roland Joffé, making his debut as a veteran director. Thank you very much.
Places in the Heart took commonplace elements, the depression, young widowhood, fighting to save the farm, and forged them into uncommon drama.
Frank, when your pa did this, how did he do it?
Most times, I lean on the table and grab hold, and he'd let me have it.
How many times?
Pa would be mad over something like this. I reckon he'd give me 10 good licks. I'm ready. Thank you. Frank, did it hurt? Frank! Frank!
Come on. Let's let old Frank be by himself for a bit.
Whenever anyone tells me that we have no royalty here in America, five words immediately come to my mind. Ladies and gentlemen, Cary Grant.
Proudly and happily make a presentation to a man we all love and admire. I have a special reason for admiring him, because I once, quite a few years ago, had the pleasure of making a scene with him. We were seated across the table from each other, and he was playing a fellow who'd had too much to drink. And in the very first take, his performance was so true that I became absolutely transfixed and completely forgot to pick up my cue until our director said, cut. So we did it again, and I did it again. I sat enthralled watching the man. Well, we finally, of course, got the scene. It was in Philadelphia Story, and that splendid actor, James Stewart, got a well-deserved Academy Award. Jimmy Stewart's decency, strength, and kindness is evident in every film he made. It would be impossible to review his film career in the little time we have. But here's a brief, loving look at some of Jimmy Stewart's work.
You got that second-page proof yet, Cornelius?
You're ready in a minute. And please don't call me Cornelius, Uncle Elmer. I told you 100 times the fellas all call me Corn. I like that.
That you can see your future with me, 'cause you'd be all so easy to love.
Oh, I feel the scream coming on right now.
You know, we'll have to face it sooner or later.
Oh, yes, starting right down on my toes. Sort of a tingling sensation.
Now, look, we can ride and pull
over on my knees. My legs are driving faster and faster and faster.
You're not really going to.
It's in my stomach right now. I'm afraid it's got me, Alice.
Stop it, you're not.
It's going up and up and up and up. It's all over my body now.
Here. No.
Join my throat now. What I can do, it's fighting to get out. I don't. I can't hold it any longer. Here it goes.
Fine.
I feel fine.
Did you enjoy the party?
Sure, sure. The prettiest sight in this fine, pretty world is the privileged class enjoying its privileges.
You're a snob, Connor.
No doubt, no doubt.
That's what's got to be in it.
What?
The Capitol Dome.
On paper?
I want to make that come to life for every boy in this land. Yes, and all light it up like that, too. You see, boys forget what their country means by just reading the land of the free in history books. Then they get to be men, they forget even more. Liberty's too precious a thing to be buried in books, Miss Saunders. Men should hold it up in front of them every single day of their lives and say, I'm free to think and to speak. My ancestors couldn't, I can. And my children will. And now, Aunt Ethel, I'd like you to meet Harvey. Harvey, you've heard me speak of Aunt Ethel Silver Knight. She's one of my oldest and dearest friends. He's the one who... Him? That's right. Well, this is the one. No, she's the one. He says he would have known you anywhere.
I
go.
As far as I could get. But you went on. Remember? The necklace, Madeline. That was a slip. I remember the necklace.
Please don't!
Oh, we're going up the tower, Madeline.
You got your brain!
Now we'll see. We'll see. This is my second chance.
I better come in over the hangars. Stop her short of the lights and don't roll into the dark there. You don't know what's there. No. Quarter turn. Make the approach. No. Full turn. Not yet. Hold it now. Hold it. No, now you're in line. Now throttle back. Don't stall it. Now don't. What's the matter? What's the matter? Have you forgotten how to land a plane? I've got no feel. I can't feel the airplane. What? No, you're diving. You're diving. Pull out. Hold on. Got it. Now straight now. You're too high.
Clarence! Get me back! Get me back! I don't care what happens to me! Get me back to my wife and kids! Help me, Clarence, please! Please! I want to live again!
I'll try to see your future.
Let me read it for you, Jimmy.
Fine, Carrie. I'd like that. Okay.
The Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences Honorary Award to James Stewart for his 50 years of memorable performances, for his high ideals, both on and off the screen, with the respect and affection of his colleagues. Congratulations.
Thank you, Carrie. And I thank the Board of Governors of the Academy for this gracious and most appreciated honor. And I'm also grateful to my fellow actors and actresses for their help and their friendship through the years. I'm grateful to producers and writers and props and grips and makeup and wardrobe and lighting and cinematographers, all of them. Well, everybody who was there with me and who helped me to get along so well between action and cut. That's a part of this Oscar belongs to them. A good part of it. And I'd also, especially, am I grateful to Frank Capra. Yeah. Frank Capra and all of the directors who have so generously and brilliantly guided me safely through the no man's land of my own good intentions to more meaningful performances, for which they share abundant credit in my heart. And finally, the audience.
all you wonderful folks out there. Thank you for being so kind to me over the years. You've given me a wonderful life. God bless you.
At AT&T, we know you never think about our torture tests.
Oh, it's just a phone.
Or about our extraordinary quality control.
I hear you fine, Mom. Australia's only halfway around the world.
Or even about how reliably we design things.
It still works. Who ever heard of a computer that works without air conditioning?
You can take everything we do for granted, because we leave nothing to chance.
It's not a total loss. The phone still works.
Whether it's telephones, long distance, information systems, or computers, AT&T.
When Sir Isaac Newton passed light through a prism, the color spectrum was born. Now, General Electric filters light through a blue glass infused with the rare earth metal neodymium. And a remarkable color spectrum is born for TV. GE Neovision. It lets more color out and less room light in for our greatest range of colors yet. GE Neovision. It puts color in a whole new light.
Years of exhaustive study.
Whoa. I didn't know you guys were going to be taking x-rays.
And a program of rigorous physical conditioning.
It's good!
To create the perfect romantic comedy.
There she was.
Everyone's talking about moonlighting tomorrow at 10, 9 central.
It's Kohl's birthday sale, and you're looking good in U.S. actionwear for men and women. $7.99 for shorts, $7.99 for tops. Cool off and save 50% on Kohl's best-selling flush mount ceiling fan. Three speeds, $49.99. Working out is more fun with an Emerson portable stereo with dual cassette. Only $89.99. Kohl's birthday sale. Exercise your right to save.
Kohl's, oh, how we value our customers.
To present the award for the best foreign language film are two people at home just about anywhere you can name. Here from the sound and opera stages of the world are Miss Faye Dunaway and Mr. Placido Domingo.
Since 1947, the Academy has honored the films of Italy, France, Japan, Sweden, Czechoslovakia, Russia, Algeria, the Ivory Coast, East Germany, Hungary, and Spain.
Regardless of the country, whatever the language, when we watch a movie, we watch ourselves.
Tonight's nominees for Best Foreign Language Film welcome three additional countries to the competition.
From Israel, Beyond the Walls. An April Films limited production.
Argentina, Camilla, a GEA Cinematográfica SRL production.
I can see. El padre Félix no es. Eduardo tampoco. Por favor, a
hable, diga algo.
Que lo cumpla muy feliz, Camila.
Ya sé quién es. Es el padre de provincia.
From Switzerland, Dangerous Moves, an Arthur Kahn production.
Chassez cet homme immédiatement. Immédiatement!
Mais que se passe-t-il exactement?
Cet homme-là, vous voyez au premier rang. Il veut entrer à moi, il cherche à me prendre. Je ne peux plus me concentrer.
From Spain, double feature, a Nickelodeon SA production.
¿Pero quién coño entra ahora? Con que cerrada, Paquito.
Es que han entrado Don Matías y el señor Alcántara.
Perdón, perdón. Bueno, vamos a ver si es verdad que nos callamos todos. Motor.
Rodando.
¡Me deprimo! 44-1 primera. Tómate la acción, Víctor.
Ya sé que no te lo crees, pero yo soy un niño.
From the USSR wartime romance, an Odessa Film studio production.
Холодало.
Можно идти.
Прощайте.
Спасибо.
Switzerland for Dangerous Moves.
Accepting the award on behalf of Switzerland, the film's producer, Mr. Arthur Kahn.
Dear members of the Academy, 8 years ago, you have honored me with my third Oscar. Tonight, you're honoring me with my force. However, it is not I whom you're honoring. It is you, distinguished members of the Academy, who with this Oscar have again encouraged independent producers everywhere to do the kind of films they believe in, knowing that far away in Hollywood, there is an Academy whose only criteria is a good and meaningful film which may be remembered for a long time. Thank you so very much for your support, for your recognition, and above all, for your continuous encouragement.
No, I just couldn't figure out why you called me back, sir.
You said the Sarge busted you, right?
Yeah, he got me busted, sir. He reported me to the captain.
How'd you feel?
Well,
you and the Sarge were good friends.
Yeah.
He was a nice guy.
Yes, he was.
Didn't you tell me that?
Yeah,
Would somebody you consider a nice guy get a friend busted?
Well...
No, speak up.
Well,
you lied when you said he was a nice guy, didn't you?
No, well, what I said was
Was Waters a nice guy or not?
No, he wasn't a nice guy. You don't turn somebody in for something like that. You give him extra duty. You threw him out for 3 stripes. It took me 10 years to get them stripes, sir.
That's right. That made you mad, didn't it?
Yes, it made me mad, all the things I did for him.
That's right. You were his boy, weren't you? You took care of the team. You ran his errands? You policed his quarters? You listened to his stories? Put the gun in the CJ's bunk?
Yes,
Sit down! It was you, Hanson, saw that night, Wilkie.
You lied about Waters. You're lying now. You were the only person out of the barracks that night. Who else could have found CJ's bunk in the dark?
It was you, Wilkie. You.
No, no, it wasn't me. It was the sergeant. He ordered me to do it. He said I'd get my stripes back. He just wanted to teach CJ a lesson.
What did he have against Memphis?
He despised him. But he would hide it because everybody liked that boy. But underneath it was a crazy kind of head, Captain. A crazy kind of head. You won't believe it. I mean, sometimes you could just feel it.
It's not that our next presenter needs no introduction. What is desperately required are some new adjectives to apply to a career that has no precedent in a town that thinks it's seen everything. Actually, it's more like a comet than a career. And at the head of that comet, Mr. Steven Spielberg.
It seems a fitting moment for us to pay our respects to the French director, François Truffaut. His untimely death cried out to be rewritten, to provide a happier ending for a man whose work and influence in film has enriched all of us. I know I share that feeling with you, and with the nominees for Best Achievement in Directing. They are Milos Forman for Amadeus, Woody Allen for Broadway Danny Rose, Roland Joffe for The Killing Fields, David Lean for A Passage to India, Robert Benton for Places in the Heart, and the winner is Milos Forman for Amadeus.
I must express my admiration for my colleagues who are nominated tonight. The result of their work is making this moment for me so much more thrilling. I want to thank Peter Schaeffer for writing the play and the screenplay, Robbie Lenz for introducing me to the play, and Sol Zenz for producing the film. I want to thank the whole company of actors and the whole company behind the camera, namely Twyla Tharp, Neville Mariner, Miroslav Ondříček, and Wolfgang Mozart. I have to greet my colleagues and students at the Columbia University Film Department. And finally, I'm very proud because this is an American movie on which a lot of Czechoslovakian artists and technicians collaborated. To get this kind of recognition from the members of Academy for this kind of collaboration, I think it's very encouraging for more than artistic or box office reasons. Thank you very much.
A girl, a beach, it is awesome, it's free, it's a lift, it's the way it should be. A kiss, a glance, it is hot, it is cool. It's breaking the rules. It's just how you feel when you know it's for real. Yeah, it's a kick, it's a hit, it's a call. Coke is it, Coca-Cola is it. Look at you, you're not the same as you were yesterday. You're looking smarter, you're on the move, and going your own way, and JCPenney's changed with you.
The Stafford Collection makes its statement from fabric to stitching, with classically tailored suits, fine shirts, and silk ties. So when you make your statement, it's sure to be an expression of quality. Stafford, a JCPenney.
You're looking smarter than ever, JCPenney.
A lot of long-distance companies would like you to think they're just like AT&T, but take a closer look and see how different they really are. No operator service, no immediate credit for wrong numbers, and no service for many small towns. Only one long-distance company gives you full service, only AT&T. Sometimes, there's just no substitute for the real thing. AT&T, the more you hear, the better we sound. Reach out and touch someone.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have, as always, saved the very best of the best for the last. To present the award for Best Picture, one among us who has passed beyond fame to become legends, happily in his own time and ours. Winner himself of 2 Academy Awards, this man has a personal strength and courage that equaled his professional skill and his daring. And if it seems that I've made this presenter a figure straight off Mount Olympus, I apologize for the understatement. Ladies and gentlemen, Laurence Olivier.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, thank you more than I have ever wanted or tried to thank anybody for such a perfectly wonderful reception. Thank you so much. I hope I won't let the occasion down too badly. I'm here to present at the Best Picture Award, and the winner for this is Amadeus. Thank you. 9 years ago, Audrey Hepburn gave us Oscars for Cuckoo's Nest, and tonight, Sir Laurence Olivier for Amadeus. What a wonderful and rewarding profession for a movie fan. Gregory Peck and Larry Gelbart asked me to speak for 55 minutes to make it a 4-hour show, but I only have 32 minutes prepared. There are 5 pictures nominated this year. All had a curious relationship in the fact that the filmmakers who made them had to fight and overcame many obstacles to make their films.
and to film their visions. One has to be proud to be a peer of the people who made Killing Fields, Passage to India, Soldier Story, and Places in the Heart. Our thanks to Orion Pictures and distributors and theater owners throughout the world who recognized Amadeus before it was released. And thanks must be given to others, because regardless of what you might have heard or what you might think, I really didn't do it all myself. To Neville Mariner, Twyla Tharp, and Joseph Swoboda, whose creative contributions to Amadeus do not fit into any Academy category. To a marvelous group of actors whose talents no longer remain unsung. And to a Mike Hausman-led crew composed of Americans, Englishmen, Frenchmen, Italians, Czechs, and 9 translators. And my love to my children, John, Athena, Josh, Dorian, to the boys from Myrtle and Monroe, and to the gang up in Berkeley who were behind the picture all the way. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is a wrap. Thank God. We've gone through 169 nominations from 52 pictures to name 24 winners. And add to that the uncountable congratulations to the chosen few, our condolences to all the rest, and tonight goes into the record book with our recommendation that the word best would be best served by not being used again until next year. In an evening filled with thanks, some long, some short, all heartfelt, our very last goes to you for being with us. Thank you. Good night, and God bless.
The Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences was pleased to share this evening with you those who made it possible. You, your viewing team. Comfort, performance, credibility, innovation, and a real commitment to quality. See the 85 Buicks now. And AT&T, the more you hear, the better we sound. And J.C. Penney, you're looking smarter than ever. J.C. Penney. And General Electric. At GE, we bring good things to life.
I'm Sander Van Oker. Later tonight on Nightline, on Oscar Night, a look at how movies deal with today's political issues. Our guests include actor Jack Lemmon and director Martin Riff.
This is Joan London. What's it like to win an Academy Award? Tomorrow morning we'll talk with Oscar winners. We'll also take you to the scenic backroads and beaches of Alabama. This week, Rex Harrison and Dustin Hoffman on Good Morning America.
A man follows his dreams and comes face to face with Christ. Martin Sheen and Eileen Brennan in an Easter special for everyone. The Fourth Wise Man, Saturday at 8, 7 Central. Sunday night, Sean Connery is James Bond in You Only Live Twice, the ABC Sunday night movie. Parental discretion advised. Subjects in foreign language film category.
Results of the secret voting are known only to the independent accounting firm of Price Waterhouse until the sealed envelopes are opened on air.
Public service message from ABC.
Tomorrow on ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings, what's an American model home doing in a Cambodian refugee camp? Helping them learn how to live in the U.S., bathrooms and all.
Turn off. No pictures.
Tomorrow, watch ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.